Hello and welcome. First things first, thank you very much for the 3000 subscribers in YouTube channel. Thank you very much for that. I appreciate it. And the next goal is to reach 3000 Elo in chess. Maybe this is impossible, so let's try to apply a more achievable goal. Okay, maybe to increase to 4000 subscribers. So today we are going to play in Bundesliga Chess League 15 team battle. The game started in 1 hour from now, in 9 o'clock, but I started a little earlier in order to solve some puzzles. And thank you very much all of you who participate for the team. Actually, I cannot provide them right now, but there are already five people. We are five people in total that we are going to play in this Bundesliga. And now let's start with some puzzles. The internet have a lot of problems in Greece. It's extremely bad, this internet. It's lagging a lot, but I cannot do much. I'm going to start with the very, very easy puzzles because I have some troubles to solve them. So let's try to solve some extremely easy puzzles. This is made in two. All right. I like them because I can increase my psychology, and after that you can play better. You see, and I'm watching a lot of people on Twitch and on YouTube as well, and I can see that they have fantastic results on puzzles. It's extremely amazing for me. I don't know how to solve them correctly, all of them. You can see I have approximately 22 or 2300 Elo points here on puzzles. It's achievable. I can teach you how to reach that Elo. It's not difficult to reach that. You can learn the basic fundamentals on the tactics, and after that you can reach it. But after that it is a little more difficult, I think, how to play. And mainly the second level, actually Lichess now have five levels on puzzles. The first one is what I'm solving now. The difficulty level is the easiest, the most easiest of all. Now we should capture the knight, right? Oh, this is tricky because we can capture the queen. He has to capture our queen. We have an intermediate check, and after that we can recapture the knight. So we are gaining more pieces, right? Or not? No, it's approximately the same, I think. This is tricky. You see, this is tricky. Some of them are really tricky, and we should think about them. So capture immediately the knight. Okay, capturing the knight, and after that he should remove the queen, and we are a piece down. For that reason, this is the only move to capture there. Now capture here, intermediate move, and after that capture the knight. Okay, and it's very annoying for me because in the most of the puzzles we should play with a piece down. This is my friend Harry's tactic. I show you a game in a previous video, and he managed to do this trick in the opening and win his opponent a little later. This is mate in two. Check and mate. Okay, straightforward. Now what? Let's threaten the queen somehow. He cannot capture the queen, and threatening checkmate as well, right? Checkmates are a little difficult. We should know all of them, all the main ideas. Now we have some tricks here. Capture, he should recapture with the king. After that we should play the king here, protecting the pawn and threatening c5. He cannot capture the pawn because the bishop is hanging, and we have four pawns, so it's winning, I think, with the ideas on c4. And these are computer tactics, because the computer generates these tactics, and actually it's not very easy to find all of them. Oh, we should capture. He will recapture, and after that we have this intermediate check, and we're winning material. Okay, this was nice. And some of them are required a lot of calculations in order to find them. Actually, the puzzle stopped very early, but some of them you should calculate a lot in order to find the correct solution. Now, what's going on? Oh, Mijina, I think now it came the message from the stream, right? I wrote something on chat and now I can see it on the screen maybe. And this is very annoying that the internet is very, very slow. And one friend of mine, my friend Sotiris, complained, he in very friendly manner of course, that at some point the video is lagging. It's very low, it's stuck, you know, something like that. And this is very bad, because the Greek internet is very bad. And I live in the center of the Athens, so if we don't have good internet here, then the whole Greece doesn't have good internet. So let's move forward. I think my microphone is it's right, it's all right, you can hear me clearly. And now, what we should do? Removing the defender, of course, we should capture the bishop and after that the knight, okay. This is the idea, typical tactic. And mainly the more advanced tactics are a combination of these things, the very easy tactics and middle tactics. But for me, I think it's alright to solve these easy tactics in order to familiarize myself a lot with them. We can capture the rook, but then we don't have a good breakthrough. Capturing here on d5 is a suicide, of course. But we have this idea to capture, and the king can go very fast against this d6 pawn, to hunt down this d6 pawn, to e6 pawn. And he doesn't have a counterplay, right? So let's capture, he will recapture with the pawn, king d4, king h4, he can capture of course here. We can recapture, and after that king h5, king d6, king h4, capture, he can capture, and we are faster. 1, 2, 3, 4, and you have 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, we are faster in that way. But as you can see, I calculated approximately 10 moves right now in order to solve the puzzles, and it's not very easy to do it all of the times, but okay, let's go. This is a check. So I think it's obvious that we should capture the rook, and after that he doesn't have a lot of things. Now we can go up and everything is just fine. Let's continue. I can see a check here on e4, but after that I don't see the continuation. Of course we can capture the rook there in the corner. This is another one, another idea. Ah, and he has a counter, of course, he can give this check and then we will have a lot of problems. For that reason, we should be very, very accurate here. Maybe we should give this check. This is very forcing move, this is check, so he has to go in the corner. Let's say if he goes here on h2, this is a checkmate, queen h4, and then we can capture the rook. If he goes on h3, then how to create another check, maybe on d7, queen d7 maybe, and then he can go on h2, and how to checkmate him, I don't know. Okay, actually f4 is the only move here, and if we have the only move, I think we should do it, right, or maybe it is the wrong approach. Seen a checkmate, f4 looks the right move, but what to do next? f4, king h3, and now what? We need something good now. Queen d7 looks okay, but he can go on h2, and after that we cannot continue. Ah, after that we can play rook e6, and actually he don't have this discover threat. Yeah, this is the correct move, and now I think rook queen d7, and after that rook e6, queen d7, king h2, rook e6, and we stop this discover attack, I think. Yeah, but the puzzle ended up very, very very, very quickly. I wasn't totally sure there. Now I can see a free piece. Let's capture the piece, and after that we can capture the bishop, right? So this is not very difficult. Now things are extremely forcing, so we have to capture there, no question about that, and we should do that. And we are faster thanks to this breakthrough f5, so Rook c4 wasn't very good. And now, I don't know. We have a check on f8, right? Oh no, what I'm doing? This is a white king. I mixed up everything. It's a black stern. Black stern, it is a check here. Yeah, it is a mate. This is check. Now this is another check. And finally, we have this checkmate. So I'm going to change the difficulty right now to make, to add more difficult problems, little more difficult problems, and see if we can solve them. So we have a skewering here. Maybe this is check or check to capture the rook. This is the first idea. But maybe it's better to give a check on g1, keeping the opportunity to capture the pawn. So queen g1, king d2, capture here. The king can go on f4 or on d3. On d3, this is a check, king c3. I cannot see this, how to continue the game, and this is not very good. So we should search for something more forcing here, something more forcing. What could be this one? Because we can just, we cannot just capture the rook, of course, because this is a checkmate on g8, on g1. For that reason, this is not correct. We should perform the checkmate. For that reason, queen g1 is the correct move, I think. We should give this check. This is a check, king d2. We can capture the pawn, and then he has three options or two. Of course, he cannot go on these two squares because we have check on e2 and then we can checkmate him. So this is out of the question. After that, after king d2, he has two options on d3 and c3. Let's say queen d3, king d3. We have another check on e2. And now he can go on c3 or on d4. I'm helping a little bit myself because, of course, after queen g1, king d2, queen takes, he can go immediately on here, on c3. And then we can give a check on e3. Maybe this is easier because queen e3 is almost mate. Queen e3, king b4. This is a check here on c5. Of course, and he should go nowhere. He cannot go anywhere. So this is a checkmate. He cannot go on c3. And after check, check, king d3, we should give this check again. And if he goes on e3, we saw the checkmate previously, so I'm not going to analyze this tree variation again. So he should go on d4. So we have queen e2, king d4. And now we need another check. How to give this check? Maybe on d2. On d2, and after queen d2, he cannot go anywhere actually, so this is the correct solution. And I think the puzzle will end up early. And we saw this checkmate. You see, already I calculated three moves. This is the fourth move, and this is a checkmate. But I calculated five moves in very easy puzzles, right? Computers say that these puzzles are easy, but they are not so easy. They are not so easy to calculate them. Now, we can capture on f2 with a queen. So queen takes f2. He cannot go on h1 because we have a checkmate on g1. So for that reason, queen takes, king h2. This is forcing, right? Check and check. After that, we need a continuation. We can give a check on g1. Oh, actually, it's a checkmate after that because we can retreat the queen on h4 again. He cannot go on g1 because this bishop is controlling this diagonal. So it was checkmate in two moves. Not bad. All right. But you can see the difficulty is completely different because in one puzzle I calculated five moves in order to solve it. Not very easy. And it has three or four sub-variations. But right now it was the previous one was very straightforward. Only checkmate in two moves, very, very forcing. It was easy to do that. This is a checkmate in two moves, check and mate, I think. Check, king a3 and checkmate. So let's perform this. It was easy. Now we can capture the rook thanks to that check, improving the heavy power here in the F line, and after that we can capture the rook. The next one, The rook is not hanging, we can capture this for free, but he can capture our knight. So we should give a check with a check or threat with a knight to do something with a knight, right? But how to do it? Of course we cannot go on d6, right? d6 he can capture, we will recapture. And after that both bishops are hanging, right? One bishop from that knight and the other one from the other knight. Okay, this is cool, I think. Cool tactic. So... Hi there. Christos GR, right? Hello, Christos. How are you doing? Thanks for your message. You're very welcome to suggest anything if you like or to participate in the team. I'm not sure if you are playing in Bundesliga team right now. And I'm trying to improve myself a little bit on tactics because I'm not very good, I think. I'm not very good for my level, you see, because I have approximately 2200 or 2300 elo points on Blitz, but on tactics I'm not very good. I don't feel very strong and I'm missing a lot of tactics during my games. And I hope you enjoy this automatic message from Nightbot. Actually, you cannot see it in a real screen. But when you see these messages live, you can see them immediately. I hide them from OBS streaming. Nice to be here, Christos. You're very welcome to say anything if you like, to ask anything or anything you like. So we have, sorry, a check here on C8. This is a check. He will go on g7, the only move, and then we cannot capture the rook actually somehow. I don't see a way, but we can give a check on a7. He can go on h6, and after that I can't see the continuation. So it should not be the right solution, this one. Or how to attack the rook, how to attack the queen. Capture immediately, the queen will recapture, we have a check. So maybe we can do it in that way. This is tricky, I think. We should give a check on c8, after that he will go on g7. This is forcing, and then we can capture his rook, threatening the queen, so he should recapture. Or no, actually we should give a check on c8, king d7, another check on d7. And then we can capture the rook, right? Because I was targeting his bishop on d6. I'm thinking not good moves. I'm thinking badly. Now, actually I didn't make a mistake, as you can see, but alright, the puzzles are easy. It's not on normal, on difficulty level. It's on easy. And if I make a mistake, I'm going to lose approximately 20 or 30 elo points. But who cares about the elo points? The important thing is to understand something and play well. This is the most important thing. Now, I'm thinking to capture the rook, but if he just captures there, he can recapture our rook on f1. For that reason, we need something for this rook. Or we need... this is a nice move. Queen c3, pinning the rook. And after that we are threatening to capture this rook with check. So I think this is the correct solution. And now we can capture this one. Okay. Now we have the next one. I think this is easy because this is check, a double attack, and he cannot capture with a bishop because the queen was unprotected. So this wasn't difficult. We should give a check with the queen somehow, but where? Maybe here. He should go back and then what? And then nothing, right? I'm thinking about one check, but okay, we have two good checks on c7 or on e5. He can go on g1, and after that how to continue the game? I can't see a double attack or something like that, because this is unprotected, but how to attack the rook? Or we have this this tricky move, queen c2, queen f2. We are threatening checkmate. Of course you can play here queen on rook g1, rook h g1, and after that we cannot give a check on h3 because his queen is protecting that square, so another difficult puzzle, right? Maybe we can play a move with a lot of imagination, something like that. A5, right, to kick away a knight, but what is the point of that? I can't see the point. We would like to kick away the queen, maybe. But no, it's not good either. You see, I stacked here. This is the easiest puzzles and I can't find the solution very easily. And if you like to improve yourself in Blitz, this is another very important thing. You should improve in short-term tactics. And short-term, I mean in 1-2 moves tactic. We should solve them very, very quickly. Because if you play Blitz less than 10 minutes or 5 minutes, we should be extremely well on that tactical motifs. We should understand everything. Give the checks, capture something. We should be aware of all of these tactical ideas. Wow, I found it finally. I found the checkmate in 2 moves. It was difficult. I know the motif, it's epaulette's mate, but I wasn't able to find it immediately, to recognize it immediately. So it was this one. Now this is extremely easy. I think we can capture the knight when we have the double attack. Maybe I'm very good on double attacks with knights. I hate them for many years, but I managed to practice a lot, to play a lot of games against these knights, and maybe I can find the solution easily. Check and capture, this is one thing. This is discover check. Whoa. Now we have, it is checkmate in 2 moves. Now we have this check, double check, thanks to our bishop. He should go on here on h7, and after that we can capture his rook. Threatening checkmate, and don't, oh. This was, oh, of course, it's mate in 1, you see. I lost to a checkmate in 1. Checkmate in 1. Do you believe it? Checkmate in 1. It's not easy. I'm saying that many times, that it's not easy. I think this is capturing here, and we can recapture our queen, so we won knight. It was a very typical tactic, the previous one. And checkmates in 1 move are not easy. We should be very careful, and when you play a game in a lot of action and firework, it's extremely difficult to find them. Yeah, I think this is, and we threatened checkmate, a double threat there, not checkmate, double threat, and capture the queen. So this is the only move. Now we need maybe a good check, or we can capture here. He will capture the knight, and this is a checkmate in 2 moves. After capturing on h7, I don't know what he can do. And by the way, on Sunday I'm going to stream for many hours, because one Greek grandmaster, Banikas, is going to create a marathon tournament. I don't know why he created a tournament like that, 5-hour tournament, amazing. But I'm going to play. I'm going to play there. It will be nice to play, I think. And of course on Sunday we have the Bundesliga, the game we are going to play today. I'm going to stream for some hours there. Maybe we will start at 5 o'clock, 5 p.m. o'clock Greek time, and I don't know if the tournament will end or not, but after that I'll jump forward to play in this, so on our regular tournament on Thursday and fifth day. Now we have another puzzle. Another puzzle, you can see this knight is unprotected. It's a black stern, right? So we have a check here to capture the knight. And he don't have any other checks or something, but yeah, we don't have any check on h1 to do any trick there, so I think this is the correct move. It wasn't the correct move, alright. Maybe to give a check on g5. I don't know. And what is the idea now? The idea is to checkmate him, right? To checkmate him. This was the real idea, not to capture the knight, but to perform the checkmate. And this is the next level of tactics, because you can see we can capture a piece. It looks very nice to capture a piece, but we cannot win after that. Yeah, because we are a rook down. I make a huge mistake here. And what will happen if he goes on... he cannot go there. So it was very forcing. Checkmate in 3 moves. I missed that one. Very bad. Alright. We cannot give a check on f6. It would be lovely to go there, but actually we cannot do it. The next thing is that we can capture here on e4. Threatening checkmate on h7. And maybe threatening checkmate on e5. Because e5, f6, and after that we can capture the pawn. For that reason he cannot do anything, I think. I guess, yes, this is a move to protect h7. Now we have this check, and we can capture here, and the knight is helping us to perform the checkmate. This is the idea. F7 square is very weak. Maybe this is a cool move, threatening. This is a very strong move actually, e6, because we are threatening the knight and f7. He cannot just remove the knight, because we can capture on f7 and then the rook. And the idea behind that move is that he can recapture, but now we have this double attack, this very strange double attack, attacking the king and the knight. So, alright. Now I think we are faster. Yeah, pushing, threatening the rook. The rook should go maybe on c4, avoiding the remaining threats. It's not easy because he has this b7 move, who you should capture, and after that you can create a new queen. This is another tricky tactic. The first move should be something like that. Oh, we should go very straight forward, pushing forward, b6, pushing again. If he just captures the rook, we can create a new queen, controlling everything. And if he goes here on b7, we should recapture with the rook. But after that, he will go on c5, right? And we cannot promote the pawn, because the rook is protecting c1. So what to do here? But actually, what else we can do after? It looks the only move. C3 looks the only move to me. C3, b6, c7, and b7 check. I can see other move. Oh, a new follower, Abba Halsva. Maybe. I'm sorry if I announced your name very wrongly. I'm sorry about that. Rook h7. Wow, this is very, very nice. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Your recommendations are very good. So you cannot do anything about that. Yeah, this is the correct move. Thanks for helping me. You're helping me to improve myself. And what is your rating? Your rating on tactics? Rook a7. Yeah, of course. Very good. Very good. I try always not to just to calculate randomly. I try to improve my thinking process, and for that reason I try to calculate what I'm going to do in a real game. You see, the real process, how to go forward step by step, and not just to try to calculate tactics. Because I know this is a puzzle, but I try to solve them in the correct way, to say like that. What I'm going to think during the real game. Now I can see a check and capturing the knight, maybe, so this wasn't so difficult. This is hanging. We can capture. The king is almost checkmated here, so we can give... Oh, this is a deadly pin. We can capture. Oh, if the queen can recapture, then what we are going to do? My idea was to capture on d5, and after rook takes d5, you can play this lovely move, rook d8, increasing the pin, right? But I don't know how to... This is a crazy move, of course, rook f8, we cannot do that. Rook f8, just pushing forward the pawn, another crazy idea. But let's go here, queen, rook takes, queen takes, and after that we have this check. What am I thinking? And he cannot block in the back rank. I'm very bad, I think, in tactics. I need a lot of practice on tactics. Definitely, I need a lot of practice. A lot of practice, because I'm thinking a lot of bad things. Not correct things. Let's capture here. He can recapture with the pawn. We can destroy his pawn structure. I will feel very happy about that. during the game, but maybe this is not the correct solution. Another idea. No, this bishop is not hanging. Let's attack the queen, where the queen should go. And usually in tactics we should find the checkmate. We should find how to checkmate the king, but at sometimes we should find how to checkmate the enemy queen, right? So we have this idea, bishop c4, attacking the queen, and queen doesn't have any real square, right? He cannot go on the d file, or yeah, he captured here. Now let's capture the queen, and the puzzle ended correctly for us. This is a check here, okay? He should go on g8, and after that I can't see the continuation. Maybe to play rook on e1, threatening rook e8, of course, to capture the queen. And actually he cannot stop this idea, right? This rook e1 is a very strong move. It's quiet move. It's a move without a threat, without something like that. So it's a very strong move. Rook e1 is a very strong move, I think. And I can't see anything else. Hello there. Marios, welcome. Welcome. What is your rating, Marios? Of course, many Greek people are watching, but I prefer to speak in English in order to improve my English. I don't say that I'm very good or something on English, but I try to improve myself and talk. And many of Greek people, I think you can understand very clearly. It's nothing bad to say Greek words on chat. It's all right. No problem about that. But I'm trying to reply in English as well. And I face a lot of problems because my channel was in Greek for many, many years. I made many videos and I have long problems with my viewers. Say, okay, why you stop speaking Greek and things like that. But you can see the world is very, very big and people around the world can see, and it's better to understand and communicate. So, Marios, welcome here. 21, what means 21? You are 21 years old, or you are a fan of Ike? Maybe, I'm not sure. So let me make a little break to take a little water, to put a little water. Speaking for 3-4 hours, it's not so easy, and we need a lot of water in order to speak for so many hours. Now we have the next puzzle here. Alright, and I think my camera is alright, so I'm going to disconnect the power. Alright, so check on f3. Doesn't look very nice. Oh, we have a checkmate idea. This is the checkmate idea. We have rook to bishop d3, threatening checkmate, and actually he cannot do anything. And after bishop d3 he can go on f4, but again we can, not there actually, we can go again on e2 to perform this checkmate. It's very, very nice. This was very nice. Very nice and very clear, very, very clean. Now we have a check here on h7. This is a very typical motif. This is very, very typical motif. And after that we uncapture the queen. Actually you don't have other good moves. More explanations needed for that puzzle, because we can capture there, the king will go in the corner, and after that we had a discovered check with a bishop on g6. And we can capture an f7. I wasn't totally sure. In any case, let's change the puzzle. We can capture, of course, an f3. The queen will recapture. And after that, what? Maybe another Facebook message. I'm sorry about that, guys. I'm recording with my camera, and I don't know how to deactivate the Facebook messages. At least now I closed my phone. I added the fly mode, so no one can call me. This is very useful, I think. What I'm thinking, to play to capture on f3 and after that play d4, you can capture the bishop. What I'm thinking, I'm not playing good. We have again the same tactic. We can capture, we can yeah, checkmate, let's say it like that, checkmate the enemy queen. Rook g8, right? Rook g8, he can capture on he can take on capture on e5, the pawn can recapture, and then we're threatening the queen and the knight, so we're winning. I think this is the winning continuation. Yeah, now we have this double threat on queen and f4 knight, so we are winning there. And I'm improving my rating here on puzzles, thanks to my friend here. Whoa, like my my brother is the fan of Ike. I don't support any team, and I don't really see football, but okay. Actually, I'm a referee on football, so I should not support any of teams. I was to play some games when I studied in Kefalonia, but I'm not playing anymore, or I'm not playing as a referee or something like that, but this is a double attack, okay, I found it. I'm not playing, but you never lose this this is how to say, this is check, and we're close to checkmate, let's check it. You should be referee forever, yeah, to call it like that. This is a checkmate in two moves, check and check on g7, the hidden square, the hidden square, literally difficult to find that one, that square. This is a double attack, okay, check and capture, you will capture the bishop there, alright, we can capture the rook. Oh, and then it is a checkmate, you cannot capture the pawn because we have a checkmate on b8. Do we have something better? Because if you find a right move, a good move, you should search for the second one, for the better one, for the better move. So we can capture on c2, and after that we can win the game, right? I don't see anything else. He's threatening the bishop, of course you can go here, or we can go here. Oh, we should be careful because bishop d1, he has this rook on yeah, I found it, he has this rook on c1, so the correct move here is to go on d3 and after that block that check with the bishop. This is the correct move. All right, I'm sorry if that is stacked a little bit. Now we have another one. The rook is unprotected here, so we have this double threat. This is a check. King will go somewhere, and after that we can capture the rook, right? It's good, I think. Or to capture the free knight. This is a free knight. This is tricky because it's an extra knight, but I think this is... Oh, it wasn't better. You see, it was tricky, but I made a mistake. All right. The next one, we have this lovely combination with knight, bishop and rook. Of course these pieces can perform a checkmate, but the accurate thinking is how to do it. It's checkmating in some moves, in 3-4 moves. This is the first. Whoa, they will destroy the building. So we have this check here on d2. If the king goes on c1, we have another check here on d3. He will go here on b1. We have another check with the rook. The king should go in the corner, and after that we can remove the rook somewhere, and this is a checkmate. So rook d2, king e1, he can go from the other side of the board. Again we have this check on d3. He should go here, and after that we have a checkmate, the Arabian checkmate, in the end of the board. In not the edge, but close to the edge. Okay, this is check. Let me be careful. Actually now it's tricky because we can give a checkmate in any square, right? Checkmate in any square. But alright, let's give this one. Now we can capture the queen This is a nice tactic. We should capture the queen. King will recapture, and after that we have this deadly pin, luring the king in the wrong square. That one, and now we are winning. This is a check with the rook, and we are winning. The knight is completely unprotected, right? We can capture the knight. The difficulty is extremely random in these tactics. Some tactics are little more difficult, some others are easier. We can capture the knight. This was extremely tricky, because we can capture the knight for free. Actually, it's winning. Yeah, I think it's winning easily to capture the knight, but we can capture the queen. The queen is checkmated there. But what is the difference? Let's say rook a7, he should put the knight on a5. We can capture with a rook. The queen should go somewhere, and then we can capture the bishop on b7. So we can capture more things immediately. I think this is the correct move, but it was extremely tricky, that one. And it doesn't mean that capturing on b3 wasn't a good move. But if we just capture there, the computer will say that we made a mistake. And this is not good about puzzles. This is something bad about the puzzles. Oh, something bad, because actually the puzzle should have one very good solution, very clean solution. But I can understand it, okay, if you would like to solve a thousand of puzzles like that and totally free, as Lichess providing them, then we should not complain a lot, right? I think now to capture and create a new queen, but if we capture here on c3, the queen can recapture back and protect this square on e1. Creating a new queen immediately, he can capture here on f7, intermediate move. This is a check. And then we can go on h6, he has another check on f8. Okay, we can go on h5. And he don't have any other check, and we're threatening to capture this bishop. What a tactic. I think this is the solution, because I can't see anything else. Extremely tricky. Yeah, we have that, and the king can escape, right? Actually, what I'm thinking, because he give that, so we cannot capture the queen. Whoa. We should capture the pawn, and he doesn't have any other checks. I didn't calculate that. I missed queen f5. I completely missed it. Now we have this check. I think this is easy. We can capture here the knight. This is a check. After that we have the skewering. I think it's very nice. And we have approximately 10 minutes for the games. So let's give this check. I think it's nice. And after that I'm going to change the difficulty again to add little more difficult puzzles. Try to solve them. Yeah, I think this is one. This one is the last one. All right, and let's create, let's add the normal tactics to see if we can find something here. We have a lot of ideas. I have a lot of ideas here, and one of them is to go on h6, because we are threatening this check on g6, thanks to that powerful bishop. And actually this could end up as a checkmate. A new follower, thank you very much. Manches, whoa. Hi there and welcome. You are very welcome to say anything you like. Where are you from? How much do you like chess? How much do you like chess? And in order to reply this question, you should reply, how many chess boards do you have on your home? Maybe this is a critical question, right? And you're very welcome to help me with the puzzles here, because I'm struggling. I'm struggling a lot. I feel beginner. I feel amateur. I play with some other players. They had approximately 2000 Elo rating, less rating than mine, but his tactical puzzles are much higher. They have approximately 25 or 26 rating in puzzles, in tactics. Amazing. So you're very welcome to say something if you like. We can capture on f7. The rook should recapture. And after that we're gonna create a deadly pin. How to create a deadly pin? But because we just give up the bishop, I'm thinking. What I'm thinking? Queen f6 is another move because we keep an eye on the knight. This is another thing. So queen f6. What he's going to do? Obviously to play knight c5 to eliminate that bishop. And queen f6 is a move without a threat. For that reason it's not good. We should not play that. Queen h6 is a normal move. Queen h6. What he's going to play? We're threatening on g6. Actually he should play something. He has a check here on e4. Queen h6, queen e4. King should go in the corner. And after that he can play knight c5 for example. And then what we're going to do? I can see a clear solution. So let's try to attack e4 by controlling his square. No, we can't. We don't have any tricks like that. Two Marios. Wow, this is fantastic. So you love chess very, very much. Very nice. Very nice, very nice. Two chess boards. Very nice. I don't know. What about queen d6? Queen d6 threatening what? We should create a threat. Definitely we should create a threat. And I can't find his threat. Let's say what? I don't know. Queen f6, queen h6, queen sum or queen. Oh, this could be the threat because queen d6 is a very nasty threat because we're threatening here g6 again and we keep an eye on his knight. He can give a check on e4, king will go on a on a1 and then he cannot improve the knight. He cannot go on c5 because we are controlling that square. This is something good, right? But he can go on b8 and then how to continue the game, right? Queen d6, queen e4, king h1, king a1, knight b8, let's say, or yeah, knight b8 is another move. And then capturing his rook, no, it's not correct. Queen c4, queen b3, queen g3. I'm struggling with these tactics. Yeah, okay, I can solve some of them. Definitely, my top rating is 2400 or something like that. But I'm struggling to find a good solution. Okay, well, maybe I'm going to play a move, I don't know. Maybe try to that, sorry, that one. I don't know, it wasn't correct. Let's see, queen f6. And not jump the puzzle immediately, but let's calculate it. Queen f6, we are threatening the pawn. He's going to give this check here, and now queen knight c5. This was, and now we can capture on f7. And if he goes here, we have this discovered check and capturing the rook. All right, difficult one. Let's put this, okay. I'm giving a thumbs up to that puzzle. I'm not do it very easily, very often, but all right. So we have something else. Let's capture here. He will recapture with a king. And after that. And after that rook h5. Queen, rook h5 threatening that pawn and checkmate. I don't know if he can do something. So it was this one immediately. So again wrong. Wrong, wrong, wrong all the times. Capture knight 6 with a rook, right? Very strange. And now here we're threatening check and this. Protected this one. It wasn't easy, right? How to perform the checkmate right now? Because we should perform the checkmate. We are... so play like that and the rook here. And we're threatening checkmate on that square. Whoa. Whoa. Difficult. One big for games and one small for practice. You are fantastic. You are fantastic. Please accept my congratulations. You are loved chess very much and you are going to improve a lot. This is very nice. Bishop d4 is one move. Bishop d4. We can give of course a check on h7, but after king queen h7, let's say bishop to f8, king f8 of course, and I don't see how to continue the game. So maybe d6, right? I don't know. We are very close to start the tournament. Let's check. This is a puzzle storm. I'm not going to do now puzzle storm. We have 2 minutes for the tournament. Okay. Some friends participate there. My friend Antonis from Kefalonia didn't participate. He promised to jump. And welcome all of you. It's very nice to play with you guys. It's fantastic. And you are going to help the team a lot. The elo doesn't matter, of course, your rating or anything like that. The most important thing is to enjoy chess. And we are playing just for fun. Now, we should give a check on h7, right? And after that, we can go here and checkmate somehow. We can give this check. But after that, we can escape. And I'm following a lot of people. Oh, another message or another notification. I can hear some sounds, but I'm not going to reply to any of them. I'm following a lot of good players, strong players, grandmasters and other people, and I ask how to improve my tactics. You see, I have 2300s, how to improve my tactics from then. And they say just solve a lot of puzzles, but I don't know if this just will help. But okay, let's give this check here. It's not correct. This check, this move, this was the right one. But why bishop to d4 was the right one? Now we should give that check. Oh, I should not jump forward to very quickly because I don't understand the tactics, all of them. Now I think we should create a Zugzwang. Oh, the tournament will start. So, good luck. Good luck. Three, I should change this one.